The dream is part-time rock star, part-time astronaut.
What's my favorite biome? Wait, this might not be scientific. Forest. I like them for running and hiking.
The rainforest. It's just so many different species there. I wouldn't actually want to go there.
Well, can it be nerdy? The microbiome.
This is like, oh, if you do research, this is like where you want to be as a high schooler.
I've been dreaming of this for a long time.
It really was a lifelong goal of mine to be an STS finalist.
I have read science news for so long, and I've always seen like the STS finalists printed on there.
A couple other kids in my school had been a finalist in scholarship, and they're like star scientists, like star students.
I felt like those like top 40 like little like celebrities, you know?
My science teacher called it like the Oscars, and I was like, oh, so is this important? I was like, oh.
This year's finalists for the Regeneron Science Talent Search was the most competitive pool ever. We had our largest number of applicants we've had since the 1960s. And that is a true testament to these young 40 finalists who are here, that their projects, their research really stood out to the top.
I think it's prestigious because STS looks into a lot of characteristics of a senior in high school.
It's those nuances that they look for, like scientific leadership, ability to communicate your research properly.
If I had to describe STS, I would say challenging, but awesome.
It's truly awesome.
Intensive, but like in the best way possible.
I would say that it is empowering.
Surreal. A few weeks ago, I got a call when I was just like in Spanish class, and now I'm just like here. Getting interviewed.
I think STS is actually one of the things that got me into research, but I never actually planned to apply.
That's what I thought at first. I don't fit up to this standard. There's no way it's gonna work out, but it did.
I never thought that I would like be in the White House. I never thought that I would like be able to have these sort of conversations.
We got to meet some amazing people, advisors to the president. If the executive office at the White House is willing to invite us there, it shows that they really believe in us.
I'm not even too stressed about judging anymore because it's like, I'm already here. Yay, let's like make the best of it.
The competition is an exciting part of it, but we're really more focused on the community aspect.
Even though there are 40 finalists, when you're here with them for like 24, 48, 72 hours, you do get to know them pretty well.
It's more like we're one team and the judges are another team and we're trying to fight the judges.
The STS experience, there's a reason why it's called an experience. It has to be lived.
I honestly don't want to leave. I feel like the week is going too fast.
We're doing so many new things and being able to be exposed to so many opportunities that we would have never had otherwise.
I'm really excited for Public Day, where we'll be able to kind of meet the public and present our projects to them. I've always found that communicating my science is one of the most rewarding parts for me.
I think at the STS right now, it's very representative of what the problems are in the world and what the upcoming researchers are trying to solve.
There's a lot of projects, but the really cool thing is there's a lot of applications of AI across a lot of subjects. So computational biology, chemistry, like molecule configurations.
Yeah, I've seen so many amazing things that are being done. People that are building prosthetics, quantum computing, biomedical imagery, and advancements, like real advancements in this field.
Everyone's projects are things that I wouldn't even have thought of or I didn't even realize were problems. So I'm not only leaving with 39 friends, but I'm leaving it with 39 different ideas of science that I didn't even know were a thing.
I think this is a week full of exposure to science that I haven't been exposed to, and that's really gonna help me grow.
Just like me, so many other scientists in the world, so many others at Regeneron, got their start because somebody engaged them in doing high school research. What we're trying to do is just trying to make sure this keeps going, that the next generation of students are gonna have opportunities to give back to the world.
I think the fact that there's so many incredible people who are STS finalists and Nobel Prize winners, it's driving really, because there are people in this group that I'm walking around in the halls with who will one day lift a Nobel Prize.
It's like almost every day I learn someone new as an STS finalist. You know, to join this alumni network of like elite people, it still hasn't sunk in yet.
People think like, oh, I'm just a student, there's no way I can like actually make an impact through my words and like through my work, but I think that's not true at all.
I hope by having events like the STS, by having this kind of platform, I can have a similar influence on other young scientists in the future.
Now this just shows to me that like I can go anywhere in my life. Like I can be an investor like Haley Bay-Barna. I can become a CEO. I'm not afraid of failure and I'm not doubting myself anymore. Like I know I have it because everyone does.
Good evening and welcome to this very special evening, the awards gala of the 2024 Regeneron Science Talent Search.
Our time at STS has taught us to hold on to the sense of boundless possibility.
The third place winner and the recipient of a $150,000 award, Michelle Way. The second place winner and recipient of a $175,000 award, Thomas Kong. The first place winner and the recipient of a $250,000 award, Achyuta Rajaram.